Well, we're in Marin County, and about 20 years ago, this was one of the epicenter of an new and unexplainable large-scale mortality of oaks and of a related species of oaks called tan oaks. And for many years, it was extremely disturbing because we couldn't really figure out what was going on. The patterns of mortality didn't match any known disease. Together with Professor Rizzo at UC Davis, we were actually able to put the pieces together. So what you see behind me are the standing dead. In this very spot, we can see the four stages of progression of the disease. To my right, there's a small tan oak, which appears to be still relatively healthy, so we assume it's still uninfected. Right behind me, there's a tree with bleeding cankers, but the canopy is still green. We don't expect this tree to be alive. It's dead and he doesn't know it. Behind us, there's a tree with the entire canopy browned. That is why we call it sudden oak death, because the entire canopy goes brown all at once. That means that that tree has died within the last few months. And around the tree that died a few months ago, there are several skeleton trees. These are trees that have dropped their leaves. We normally estimate these trees have died 1 to 3 years ago. And what's going to happen next is these trees are going to fall down because of the decay agents. They become very, very active in trees that are killed by Phytophthora or more. So our forests are facing now two challenges. One is given by invasive organisms. Phytophthora ramorum is one of them, and correlated organisms like bark beetles and these kind of organisms that are secondary. And the second challenge is by these microbiome endophytes that become aggressive pathogens. The predictions are that in the near future, the two types of diseases will significantly change the range and the distribution of our native trees in California. The magnitude of the problem caused by endophytes is not understood yet because this is a new phenomenon, but we understand a little bit better the magnitude of the mortality caused by sudden oak death. And it has been estimated recently that close to 200 million trees have been infected and over 60 million trees have been killed. So if you think about California, our population is what, 40 million or so? So this would be basically wiping out every single Californian that lives in the state. So this is a fairly major impact on our ecosystems. And it has been shown that the presence of sudden oak death-induced mortality for a certain period of time really increases the fire for the risk for wildfires. So wildfires become a lot hotter and they behave much more erratically when you have oaks and tan oaks that have been killed by sudden oak death. The availability of two genomes all at once, sequenced at the Joint Genome Institute, allowed us to do comparative analysis and understand how these two pathogens have evolved to be very aggressive and how they interact with hosts. The results of the comparative analysis of the genomes of these two important Phytophthora species were published in 2006 in a highly cited paper in the journal Science.
So we're injecting oak trees as a preventative measure for sudden oak death. This is a phosphorus compound, phosphite or phosphonate, which is injected into the tree and aids the tree in fighting the infection.
The injection boosts the immune system and the response of the tree to infection, making it more resilient and more capable of actually fighting off the pathogen as it's trying to kill it. We've been really interested in understanding why are trees more resistant after injection. And that's one of the applications of the genome that was provided by the Department of Energy Joint Genome Institute. The organism was sequenced really early on when it was discovered, and we've used that sequence to understand how the pathogen responds in a plant that's being treated with the phosphate. And the result was very interesting because we were able to show that the plant treated actually becomes basically a resistant plant.